private company has taken astronauts into space for the first time ever. Once a Cold War battleground, space exploration is now big business. European scientists say mining the moon could be a reality in as little as 5 years. So can we do it? Or is moon mining sheer lunacy?
It's one small step for man.
One giant mine for mankind? We've exploited the Earth to the detriment of our environment and our cultural heritage. So is the answer to look skyward? Private companies like the Asteroid Mining Corporation or Moon Express think so. They're all in the game of off-Earth resources.
Not only is it feasible to mine the moon, but I think it's going to happen, and I think it's going to be economically profitable.
And it could happen soon, but should we be letting it? Well, let's look at three things. What would we mine for? Could it be sustainable? And how would it be governed? What would we mine for? Water. For starters, anyway. The ice on the moon can be melted into H2O and then split, extracting the hydrogen to make rocket fuel, which means we could put a petrol station on the moon.
If you have spacecraft landing on the moon and launching off the moon because you're doing things on the moon, then you can refuel while you're there.
Dr. Phil Metzger worked at NASA for 30 years and has invented a method for mining moon water. He says fueling up in space would mean smaller rockets plus cheaper and further space exploration. There's also a lot of helium-3 on the moon. That's fuel for waste-free nuclear energy. Not to mention gold, platinum, rare earth elements, and a whole heap of other materials that can be used in next generation electronics that can make Earth more sustainable, like massive antennas made in space from moon materials.
We could put the entire computing industry in space, and then all the energy demands of the computing industry can be put off of our planet.
Which brings us to, could it be sustainable? Science philosopher Annie Hanmer says there are two ways of looking at it.
If you think about space as a pristine wilderness, then in that sense, you give it some sort of value for humans in it being a wilderness, then it's natural to say it needs to be protected.
But we can also muse on whether it's actually better to mine an asteroid or a moon instead of Earth.
Because as far as we know, there is no life on the moon. There isn't life on asteroids. So what are we destroying?
She also asks about us. Do we have to be a society that needs to keep mining things? What happens if we pollute the moon or damage the moon craters that carry millennia worth of scientific history and evidence?
We could avoid repeating what we did on the Earth if we have the foresight.
If we have the foresight. We've already got a mindset of infinite growth, finite resources here on Earth. And how on Earth do we rein that in space? In other words, how would it be governed? And is it even actually legal? In short, kind of. No country can claim sovereignty over the moon, or any bit of space, and there is a treaty that allows mining, as long as it's governed by international regulation. Did Russia sign that one? No. Did China? No. Did the US? Nope.
They want their companies to be able to say to shareholders, if we go and mine this thing, we get to keep the profit.
Mining the moon might be plausible, even legal, and it could even help us avoid further destroying Earth. But with private companies leading the charge, I don't know. History is littered with examples of pillaging for profit in truly awful ways, yet profit has pushed exploration, science, and technology to where it is now. The question is, have we as a civilization learned from the mistakes of our past? I'm ideologically opposed to mining the moon, but I can't deny it could do a lot of good, but only if it is actually a giant leap for all of humankind and not just to line the pockets of billionaires and their shareholders.
Hey, if you enjoyed that, make sure you subscribe to The Feed's YouTube channel.
And you can watch these videos here. See you next time.